Welcome to Pathologic Classic HD. Normally my introductions for new series are really short, but there really are some things I need to explain about this game before I just jump into it. So the original version of Pathologic came out in 2005, and since its release it's become a bit of a cult classic. A lot of people really love the game and there's something very special about it. However, the original version of Pathologic had one major flaw, and that's the translation. The game is made by Ice Pick Lodge, which is a Russian company, and the original version of the game is in Russian. And this is actually the first game that they made, and so they didn't have that much experience making games, and unfortunately the company that they hired to do the translation from Russian to English did a horrible job. Not just kinda bad, they did a abysmal job. It's almost as if they took the original Russian text and just ran it through Google Translate and called it good. It's really that bad. It makes it so hard to understand anything that's happening in the game, and it's already a game that, on its own, is very hard to understand because it's very surreal and very strange. A while ago, Icepick Lodge launched a Kickstarter to do a remake of Pathologic, which was thankfully very successful, and they're actually working on it right now. But when doing the remake, they realized that their remade version of Pathologic is going to differ from the original in a lot of ways, to the point where it really is a separate game, not just an improved version of the game, but actually a different game. So, although they're working on the remake right now, and that has yet to come out, they decided that they also want to preserve the original version. And that's what this version is. Pathologic Classic HD is the original version of the game, not remade, but basically remastered. And the most important thing is that they fixed the translation, which was by far the biggest issue with the original game. And of course, it was their first game, so I'm sure even with the translation fixed and the graphics improved, it's still going to be a very flawed game, I'm sure. But I remember many years ago I tried to play it, and I could not get past the translation. It just made no damn sense, I was so confused all the time, and I ended up never finishing it. So I'm hoping now I can finally experience what so many other people saw as an amazing game. Now with the translation fixed, maybe I can experience that as well. If you'd like to play this game for yourself, as always, you'll find some links in the description, and let's jump right into it.
So, it's all about trickery to you? Wherever have you come from?
No. I detest trickery. But if we ourselves are to suffer deception, our hands are no longer tied. Where are we?
Well, the muscular contraction is there. Means you're already inside of him. This must be one of the ventricles, right here.
What a silly place. It's stuffed. So it's not real for now? I don't think it has started yet.
Does it matter what it's made of? It's definitely struggling. We need to perform sectio transversalis. Cut the wall. There's no other way out. What else is there to do?
I know what to do. Those who favor hard logic and direct action are bound to be misguided. Only a miracle can set us free without us having to destroy something. And I can do miracles. Just let me.
Will you please be quiet? You're a liar and a thief. Who's going to believe you when you keep lying to yourself? The truth is my shepherd. Whatever happens, I will find answers, and justice will be restored. I will perform the operation. Medica morbo adhibe.
Don't you go all bossy on me, clever clogs. You will act justly, but your justice will blind you and become his demise. This calls for the gentle hand of a surgeon. Step aside, both of you.
Your gentle hands are used to killing, not giving life. You will inevitably do harm. As for Brainy, he has no regard for casualties at all. Neither of you knows compassion.
Yes, it seems unlikely that we'll get along well, but there's only one truth.
Any choice is right as long as it's willed. That's the truth of the matter.
Heart will show you the right choice. Stop thinking about yourselves. Think of the sick. He's in pain. I can't see it yet, but I can feel it.
It's not even a trap. It's a grave. Subipsum funus sumus. Can't say I hold a soft spot for it.
I can see that. You're full of hate, Stuffed or not, it's breathing. I can hear it. It can be healed rather than killed.
You mean you won't become a killer? But you will. Mark my word, that's exactly what will happen. But I can avoid it.
No, we won't ever get along. I suggest we be on our way. The sooner the better.
Off we go then?
Let's go. The clock is ticking.
I don't know if I've ever seen that conversation till the end. All the actors on the stage, just frozen, lights off. That's so cool. Yeah, that's not a cutscene or anything like that. This is where the game starts, and you see all these actors on the stage, and you can leave at any time and go to this door. And once you go through the door, it allows you to select which character you want to play as. But you can listen in on the conversation. And it's so cool. This game is, it's kind of meta in some ways. Some ways that you'll see a little bit later. But those actors on the stage, I believe, are actually the three characters that you can choose from. They're kind of arguing over who's the right person for the job. And it's so funny, because right after their argument, then you have to decide, who do you want to play as? Which of those three people on the stage do you want to be the... To inhabit. Which one do you think is the right person for the job? It's so cool. Yep, so now we get to make our decision, and I'm pretty sure those are the three people from the stage. I think this was the guy in the back. This was the guy standing, like, with the doctor's bag. Kind of halfway on the stage, and then that's, of course, the woman. Okay, so this is the changeling, which we cannot pick until we've actually... finish one of the other storylines, so we have these two people to choose from. I'm gonna go with a bachelor. I've heard that they're the best character to go with for a new player. And even though I have played this game before, it's been so long that I really don't remember how to play. So I think I'm gonna go with them. The history of humanity witnessed a number of catastrophes that have demonstrated, without a shadow of a doubt, the pettiness of human achievement, and the triumph of the invincible evil. Outbreaks of infectious diseases that have, from time to time, wiped towns and cities off the map are undoubtedly among those. However smart and virtuous, the people caught up in these destructive events have repeatedly come to the conclusion that it's no use trying to fight these circumstances. The best you can do is bite the bullet and cope with your losses. This is the story of a person who has managed to work a miracle and defeat a seemingly unvanquishable foe.
Daniil Dankovsky, a bachelor of medicine, was brought here by circumstances most unfortunate. Dankovsky's life work, his theory challenging the existing notions of human mortality, is being harshly persecuted by the powers that be. Suddenly, a letter arrives from a colleague suggesting that there is previous undiscovered evidence which may support Dankovsky's claims. There is a settlement, the letter says, ruled by an extraordinary man who may well be seen as objective proof of Dankovsky's daring hypothesis. Grasping at straws of hope, Dankovsky decides to follow what he believes to be the sign of divine providence. Without further ado, he sets off for the settlement. Late at night, Bachelor arrives in the town. As he seeks room and board, he gets to know a girl called Eva Yan and stays at her place till dawn.
As of today, my mission remains obscure. The examination of Simon Kane, who is rumored to be a man of incredible longevity, may shake the very foundation of modern thanatology and challenge the existent notion of death itself. However, even if this undying Leviathan proves to be more than a fairy tale, the mere confirmation of his existence won't suffice to prevent the powers that be from shutting our laboratory down. I need to figure out the most fruitful approach. Simon is a well-respected man, and if he mistakes my interest for effrontery, it would be nigh impossible to convince him to help me break new ground in the field of human vitality. Alright, so I'm a doctor who's come here on a quest to find the person who's beaten death, basically. Beaten mortality. Supposedly. Day one, by the end of which the bachelor finds himself battling a truly unvanquishable foe. So we're staying at the woman's house. Your house, Ava Yon, I believe your name is.
I had a feeling you would come.
Do the sounds from outside wake you up too? There was a terrible groan, and then something snapped loudly. I fell asleep so quickly I didn't even notice. It's like I fainted. What sounds are you talking about? I think there are strangers in the backyard, by the pond. They're unlikely to be planning mischief, but I have a bad feeling about this. I'm afraid to go out to them. I hope they go away soon and stop disturbing our sleep. Why do you think they aren't planning anything foul? Our population is so thin. Crime is basically non-existent, especially here, in the stone yard. Sometimes there are pranks, of course. Fights happen occasionally. People are young here, so they often go out at night. But we're a tight community. And now I hear unfamiliar speech. That's not a good sound. I'll go out and take a look. But I'm in a hurry. I must see this founding father of yours. Are you willing to trade the company of a charming woman for that of a dreadful old man? Even if he is a sorcerer? That's so sad. But Simon won't go anywhere. He is. He has always been. He always will be. Even if the moon were to fall to the ground. Please, stay with me a little longer. Simon is a sorcerer? Did I hear you right? Is that the secret to his longevity? Did he cast a spell? Are you in that much of a hurry? Do come round. The Canes are asleep now. Take your knockabout coat off. Have a rest in my bed. Let me warm your hands. You're so anxious to see Simon, as though your life depended on it. My life? Yes. Now that my laboratory is on the brink of destruction, my whole life's pursuit depends on that remarkable man. If he has really managed to live that long, then his tissues will help me defeat death. Death. So that's the enemy you've chosen for yourself. Isn't it hard? I don't think anyone has managed to defeat that evil yet. Millions of doctors defeated it on certain singular occasions, but my enemy is more fearsome. It is death itself, rather than a singular case of death. I don't understand. I can barely understand it myself. Could death only seem inevitable to us, but in reality be nothing more than a whim of the will that had shaped this world? That is the question. So where is the key to my victory? It's not far. The Canes live at the Crucible, on Bridge Square. But could I please offer you a piece of advice? Go on. Simon has two younger brothers. The eldest of the two, Georgie, is called the Judge by the locals. Visit him first. He isn't asleep. He'll teach you how to speak with Simon. The youngest of the three is Victor. His daughter, Maria, also wanted to see you. It's probably important. Was it she who knew about my arrival beforehand? Yes, she told me about it privately. Talking to her is no simple task. Maria is that kind of person. She puts on airs, but that's just how the Canes are. It was Maria who told me that she would help you defeat death. That's the precise wording. What a coincidence. All right. Thank you for the advice. Go, and I'll prepare everything for your return. Do come back after you speak to the Canes. They will probably do a lot of things that will puzzle you and put you on guard. I will have some advice that may be of help to you, if you need it. Okay, I'll come back. Alright, so this is where I'm currently at. This is where I need a visit to go meet with the Canes. This is the size of the game world, by the way. It's pretty damn large. This is definitely an open world game, by the way. Okay, so there we go. We have our quest to go speak with the Canes, try to learn about his supposed secret of longevity, and also go speak to the people outside that are making weird noises. So yeah, if you have never experienced this game before, it is very strange. It has strange but fascinating music, strange but fascinating characters. It's slow at times, awkward at times. It really doesn't hold your hand for the most part, and you can get so freaking lost in this game and have no idea what's happening. But maybe I'll have more of an idea what's happening with the new translation. But what I'm saying is, hold on tight for the ride of this game, because it's going to be strange, it's going to be weird, but I think it's going to be worth it. Did I mention this game was strange? Did I mention it was meta? Because it totally is. Halt. I'm going to have to teach you about the technicalities of the setting, the time and place. It's not essential, but that's just how it is. The actor has to be prepared before he goes on stage, or else he'll fall down the aisle or stumble upon the prompt box. That would look mighty silly, wouldn't you agree? You're going to have to teach me? Aren't you forgetting your manners, executor? My manners. There are different manners of life and thought, none of them mine. If everything goes awry, you'll get a chance to witness each of them. That is something you should probably try to avoid. As for now, please forgive my rudeness. I'm in a special position here, and so I have the right to be blunt sometimes. And who are you? An actor in a tragic mime show. That's unimportant. Will you listen to me or not? I'm listening. Time flies by. It can't be stopped or turned back. Nights follow days, which are then followed by nights. Things happen without any regard for whether you're there to witness them. Don't expect anyone to wait for you. Most events can be missed. And so, it would make sense for you to visit the places that you care about regularly. You'll find the people that will play major roles in your fate there. They stand out from the common folk. The rest are just a crowd shot, a background, a bunch of extras. As it has always been. Indeed. Still, it's best to avoid hasty judgment. It's a paradox, you see. Don't try to care too much for the lives of these bound-to-stand-out people. And don't be too dismissive of the silent crowd. Both extremes will end in tragedy. Why is that? This world cares for your reputation, a fine and crucial instrument. Your reputation changes the world you see, for it is a mirror. Wouldn't you agree? And so, a bad reputation can get you into a lot of trouble. For example? Oh, need I describe? You've got vivid imagination. Everything changes. From mystical aspects to mundane things like the people you need treating you badly, how many enemies you've got, how high the prices rise, how bad your dreams are. Lots of things. A sorry prospect. So how do I maintain my reputation? Really? How is that even a question? Same as anywhere. Thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not lie, thou shalt not betray, do not steal, do not covet, Do not be an asshole. Do not get caught. The rules are the same everywhere. A truly selfless deed, like risking something for thy neighbor, or even a person who lives quite far away, can help in a dire situation. I see. Really? Good for you, then. As for me, I can't see a thing in this mask. I have no idea what's going on. Anyway, don't get too worked up about human lives, and don't put too much stock into another's words, mine included. He who trusts everyone is asking to be deceived. Yet he who trusts no one is deluded. I know that from experience. I love that conversation so much. Are you ready to have another one? Venerable Bachelor, please be so kind as to linger for a minute. This conversation won't take too much of your time, especially since time stops during dialogues, at least during the important ones. And our dialogue is extremely important. You need to know how to play after all, don't you? It's so meta. The tragedian. I just love how some of these dialogue options are phrased to play. What are you talking about, mask man? I'm neither a gambler nor an actor. Of course you aren't. You are a living, breathing man, as is evident from your conditions and statuses. You experience hunger, thirst, and fatigue. You suffer from pain, wounds, and diseases. You're so lifelike. You have to eat, drink, sleep, and rest, and to make mistakes. The latter being the most definitive proof of my human nature, wouldn't you agree? If I may, I would like to point out how important it is to keep an eye on your condition. If you get dizzy or unnaturally sluggish, do have it checked up. Vital processes tend to run faster during emergencies than in everyday life. I knew a person who died of stress, but was diagnosed with starvation. It happens. I can testify to that as a doctor. Need I remind a wise man like you of the fact that hunger is sated with food? Food can be found in shops, and shops can be found in ordinary houses that are marked with specific signs. Sleep, however, is more complicated. People only sleep in beds, and only in private residences around here. I'm sorry, but that's just how our world is. Yes, the world is unjust. And quite silly, if you forgive me for saying so. Speaking of commerce, different shops sell similar items at different prices. Make sure you don't get cheated. People can be quite brazen around here. You can also barter with the folk out in the street. Some things may be nothing more than trinkets to you, but others would be willing to part with their life's blood for them. Blood? Yes, blood. It's not my place to lecture you, but if, following your Hippocratic oath, you ever consider easing someone's pain, feel free to just approach them with a suitable drug. You will see their pain receding before your very eyes. The sick fall asleep when they're close to recovery, don't they? Or when they're close to their ultimate rest. Still, helping the hopeless will grant you a good reputation. You will be seen as a benefactor, willing to part with a precious sleeping draught or a painkiller for a simple bystander. Anything else? No, not yet. Bye then, mask. These conversations are just amazing. Like, what an introduction to a game. That's essentially the tutorial right there. And yes, everything they said is true. Time will continue to pass. Like, look at that right there. Time's passing right now. So I don't want to dawdle for too long. By the way, just to give you an idea of what I've got on me, I've got 1,400 monies. I have a scalpel, which I can use as a weapon, by the way. Let's put that away, though. Don't want to scare people. Ruin my reputation. Also got gloves. Also got some things like a tourniquet for bleeding. Some morphine, some meridorm, which is also a painkiller, and also this, which is for immunity. But I don't think I have to worry about that right now. I've got some water on me. And also some kerosene for a lamp. A lamp that I apparently don't have. Oh, yes, and my statuses. They're indeed important. Very, very important. Reputation right now is good. Health is good. Immunity is decent. Not hungry, not exhausted, not infected. So, doing well right now, of course. That's my list of adherents. I don't even know what that means. Apparently you can get adherents. Don't know what that's about. Okay, so these are the people that have been making noise outside of Ava's place. Let's go talk with them. They've noticed me. I love the music in this game. It's so good, it's so strange, and it has this kind of droning quality to it that almost... It creeps me out, but it kind of lulls me to sleep, sort of, too. It creates this strange, dreamlike feeling. I love that this person's avatar on the bottom left is a little ragdoll. It looks like it's smiling. It's a happy ragdoll. What do you want? This ain't your business. What is this creature? An Odung. Duh. That's what all them cattle breeders look like. Crude and unshapely and unfinished. Don't you know? Wherever you came from. An intruder, huh? So that's what the cattle breeders look like. Crude and unshapely and unfinished. Why would the cattle breeders be unfinished? Yes, I'm a visitor in this town. Who could have thought it's home to such creatures? An unfinished man. Well, who's to say it even has a gender or a sex, an unfinished person? The worm feels sick, head packed, blood boiling, belly freezing. Let the worm warm up. Let him take a rest. Don't touch us. We're dangerous. And sometimes you have to say really rude things. So I can either tell them to go away or just kind of insult them and then leave them. They are bothering Ava, but at the same time, they're not really doing anything. It seems cruel just to force them to go away when all they're doing is just warming up at a fireplace. So I'm just gonna leave them. Unfortunately, I have to leave them with this rather rude option. Whoa, that's some stench, you animal. How on earth do you even live like that? I really wish you didn't have to say that, but you do. Oh, and sometimes you see a money symbol show up in the top left of the screen. It did just there. I think that's you finding money on the ground as you walk around. Just coins on the ground, I guess. Ooh. Some water. A gold ring. Can probably sell that. Oh, that's not water. Sorry, that's just a bottle. Yeah, this game becomes very heavily about resource management, by the way. Resource management and also managing your bars. Immunity, hunger, exhaustion, infection, so you need to be very careful. You need to be very stingy and fill up your bottles and try to collect any loot you can and... Oh. 7 o'clock. Lights turned off. Okay. Let's go visit the people we are supposed to. Okay, that's where Simon Kane is. But I don't want to visit Simon Kane first, because Ava told me to talk to her, his brother first, so let's go here first. Yeah, there we go. Top left corner. Just picked up 2 coins, I think. It's either that or, like, I lost coins. Maybe there's a hole in my pocket or something. I don't know. Dang, that's a lot of empty bottles. Okay, which place is this? Victor Kane, Simon Kane's brother. And this is where Maria is. So it says Simon Kane is waiting for me here, but it also says that Georgie Kane is waiting for me here as well. And it's Georgie I'm supposed to talk to, so maybe I do need to go there first. Oh yes, and that strange thing in the distance. I believe that is the polyhedron. It's interesting. I'll show it to you later. It's very strange. Hello? Okay, hold on. Who are you?
I'm too old. Nothing can harm me anymore.
Are you Simon? I think that's Simon, but it also says this is the mansion of Georgie Kane. So where's Georgie? I don't know, but I don't want to talk to you yet, because I haven't learned how to talk to you, I think. So let's go to the other places first, then. It's an upside-down person. You're Victor, right?
He's buzzing in my ears.
The famous Dr. Dankowski. Your arrival is a great honor for us. Victor Kane, at your service. Daniil Dankowski, at yours. I foresee that the things that have become ordinary for us will probably make you feel uncomfortable and disturbed. I would like to compensate for that impression. You know, our small community has fallen out of the loop. Time leaves us behind. What do you mean? I mean the traditions. Games that we play with passion will most likely be of no interest to you. The people you meet here may seem eccentric, naive, or even somewhat deranged. Please, take it easy on us. Don't judge us too strictly. I will do my best not to disappoint you.
I feel as though my blood is getting thicker. An omen, is it not?
Ooh. What does it feel like to have your blood get thicker? I don't want to think about that. Georgie is waiting for you, my friend. He has news for you that you'll find surprising. I only ask one thing. Don't be too quick to reject his request. What does he want from me? He will explain it better himself. We put too many hopes in your arrival. The echo of these hopes has led him to offer you a rather intricate conundrum to solve. What is it? It's not exactly in your line of work. And yet, if we are to believe a certain source, which we deem quite trustworthy, it appears that you are the only person that can help our family. The reward will be fitting, of course. All right, I'll speak to Georgie. So the Kane family needs help with something. kind of an image is that to have on your wall? And a broken mirror? So creepy. Why are all the mirrors broken?
Why can't I move on my own? The Sabarovs' wait is over. They've always wanted an heir.
You resemble an adventurer rather than a doctor. Appearances can be deceiving. I saw you in a dream. Don't flatter yourself. My desires have nothing to do with that. I simply saw you take us all by the throat. That's not a good dream. What else did you see in that dream? I'll tell you when I think I can trust you. I hope that happens soon.
I think I'm having fever heat.
It's really strange when you talk to NPCs, they say some random line that has nothing to do with what they're actually talking about here. It's very strange. Anyway, I have a lot to tell you, Bachelor Dankovsky, but I dare not, until you meet my uncle, Georgie. Otherwise, he'll rip my tongue out for disclosing a secret. Some strict morals your family has. They make much more sense than you might think. This is not a game, is it? For all that is holy, do speak to my uncle, and then come back to me. Otherwise, the excruciating anticipation will tear my heart to pieces. Okay, where's your uncle now? Close at hand, just next door. Go to the wing that's closer to the river. Its roof is shaped like a crown. Alright, I'll be back soon. The wing that's closer to the river. Shaped like a crown. So, this one? Oh no, that one's shaped like a crown, right? I mean, it's gotta be the last one, because I've already gone to the other ones, right? I've already spoken to Victor and Maria. Ooh, is that a fountain? Oh, no. Can't do anything with it. I guess it could be a fountain that's dried up. So that's this one, right? So is this Georgie?
The town will meet its death at the hand of Simon's murderer. That much is certain.
Wait. Did he just say Simon's murderer? Are you telling me Simon's dead? I think he might have just given it away. Okay, hold on. My most venerable doctor, it is with great impatience that we have been expecting you. You need not delve into the minutiae of your business with us, since our family is well acquainted with your scholarly work. We're also quite aware of the difficulties you are experiencing and well prepared to do our utmost to support you. It hurts me all the more to be the one to inform you that Simon, my consanguineous brother, the creator, keeper, and embodiment of all that surrounds us, has been murdered. Shit. Welp, that ruins my plan, does it not? I needed him. I can't believe it. It cannot be. My brother was murdered last night, under the strangest of circumstances. But, for all the mystery surrounding his death, I'd rather eschew the notion that his departure was connected with whoever had visited Simon that evening. The visitor is a man of laudable rectitude and an old friend of our family. There are witnesses to testify that he and Simon did nothing but converse. Doesn't want the word out about the visitor. Well, regardless, I want to know who the visitor was. Someone you know quite well. The man who my brother saw last night was your colleague. Isidore Barak. Was he not the very person to advise you to come here as well? Yes. Isidore has done more than he thinks. I have a lingering feeling that time itself is using uncontestable powers to further its own intentions. What do you think? Categories like time, nature, and fate deprive man of responsibility for what goes on around him. I was taught to avoid this worldview. It could be that my mind is clouded by sorrow, but I cannot escape the feeling that your arrival was no coincidence. Your choice was made for you, my dear doctor. Let us not blame fate for it. Isidore wrote to you without making us aware. He took a risk that could have displeased our family. Why do you speak the word fate with such disgust? I prefer the word time, in a fatalistic sense of the notion, of course. So Simon wasn't aware I would come? Even though we were uncertain of when you would arrive, my brother was looking forward to meeting you. The tragedy may have been a consequence of the actions he took in preparation for your arrival. Someone has taken a powerful piece from the chessboard. A piece upon which your position here depended. It is doubly regrettable that Simon was playing on your side. So you presume the queen knew of the blow and sacrificed itself for a pawn. But why? To grant you victory over death? Was it not your ultimate aspiration? To help you, Simon seems to have played a very dangerous game with fate itself. He went out of his way to provide you with a body of evidence. What did he do? It is of no importance to me what exactly he did. He took another leap for the stars, and paid a terrible price for it. I repeat, he was murdered. The subject of importance here is the identity of the murderer. Everything has gone to rack and ruin. I wish I could take vengeance upon the person who ripped the life from this man. Do you want to help us, Doctor? Find the murderer for us. My brother Victor, who's in the wing next door, would share some of his thoughts on the matter. Help us, and the reward will not disappoint you. Indeed, it seems there are too many coincidences. Your brother's murder can just as well be called the murder of Bachelor Denkovsky. I will help you in every way I can. I am convinced that if there is anyone at all that can help us solve this puzzle, then it is you. This mission calls for someone as astute and inventive as yourself. If Isidore was an instrument of fate, then Simon's murder is a message that fate intended for you personally. Do not think I'm inclined to blame you for that. I'm not. How do you plan to look for the murderer? We will take our own measures. The only thing I expect from you is to be yourself. Do only what you think is required. Whatever you find out, whatever you do, whatever your day turns into, everything is a clue to the solution of this puzzle. I repeat, everything that is happening here is happening on your account. Everything that's happening here is happening on your account. It's like, it is like this is a play, isn't it? As if the play is only happening because I'm watching. As if I'm the audience for the play, and if I wasn't here, the play doesn't continue. Which might be a commentary on the game itself. The fact that the game only... the play only happens when you load it up. As soon as you leave and shut down the game, the play stops. Everything is happening because of me. You have my sympathy. I just marked Victor. Okay, so we need to go speak with Victor and then also talk with Maria. You should be able to offer me some more information about what happened with Simon.
That does it. I'm gonna break soon.
Georgie has told me everything, which is to say he told me very little, but it was enough to astound me. He maintains that you can provide a more detailed account. So you have agreed to help us. I have. May I ask why? The killer's goals seem to align astonishingly well with the goals of those who've been waging war against my work for years. I'm prepared to answer any questions you may have. When was Simon last seen? He sent Isidore home. Then an hour later, he came to this hall to see us. He announced his plans to withdraw, to the focus and receive no one. He told us not to approach the focus and to fast for a week, partaking of neither meat nor water. Then, in the morning, he was found dead. That's a very strange thing to happen right before his death. Fast for a week. Why? And also, what is the focus? Why no meat or water? Our explanation is that he wanted to be mourned beforehand, as is the custom with the local people. This is very like him. Wait, so he knew in advance that he would die then? I think, between me and you, that this is precisely what my brother Georgie fears. I can say nothing more about that. How's the body discovered? The servants discovered him in the morning. The room had been ransacked. Everything that was breakable had been broken. His disfigured, contorted body bore signs of terrible suffering. His neck was twisted, his spine broken, I think. No one has touched the body. It's currently inside the focus, and will remain there for the prescribed amount of time. What's this focus place? It's hard to explain. It's his study, if you will. An extraordinary, spacious, creative laboratory. Almost perfectly sealed off, except for the door that was visible at all times, metaphorically speaking. What? I don't understand. It's like an equation, or a mirror puzzle. Anyway, the murderer could not have been hiding there. Take my word for it. Wait, so the door is always visible, metaphorically speaking. It sounds like there's a hidden door to this laboratory, the focus. A hidden door that's somehow in plain sight, but it's not obvious that it's actually a door? Well, Simon did get in there somehow. He could perform far more impressive feats. There's a reason why the whole town revered him. Alright, so how can I help you? Just take a look around. Trust your intuition. Do whatever you like. Speak to whoever you feel the need to. Look for the murderer, Doctor, and you will find them. Keep looking till the last breath. I'm sure your rational thinking will help you. Okay, so Isidore is the only lead. How can I find him? I'll show you, but you must be careful. Simon's murderer, whoever they are, could not be an ordinary person. I can't imagine them even being a person. I fear it could only be fate, wearing the guise of a mysterious monster. I'll be careful. This is where Isidore Barak lives, the man that had brought me to this remote place. He is the last person that had seen Simon Kane alive. Oh god, that's really far away. It's on the other side of town. Anything more to say?
I fear that Simon's death is-
Nope. Alright, let's go speak with Maria. There's something she wanted to tell me. Oh, what time is it? 8. Still plenty of time left in the day. 8 a.m. Okay, what did you want to tell me?
What?
Now listen, closely. The time for collusion, secrets, and alliances has come. I'm going to ask something of you. I am not used to that. I'm used to holding the reins. But you are not harnessed, so it would be unacceptable to address you in this manner. I find solace in the fact that my request will be welcome with you. It fits the style of your venture. I'm not an adventurer, and my job is no venture. I hope it never becomes one. I apologize if my words come across as mangled and silly. I am truly not used to asking. But the nature of my request demands complete and selfless humility. Just imagine me begging and kneeling. And believe me, I do feel that way. No need to kneel. What did you want to talk about? Today's death was the first, but it won't be the last. Simon has opened the score of irreplaceable victims. Soon their numbers will multiply. I beg you to preserve the lives of several people when the lines of their fortune cross yours. Before any of them dies, there will be a moment when you will be able to intervene. I know that for a fact. How? I had a vision. I'm clairvoyant. I will become the Nocturnal Queen soon, just like my beloved sorceress mother used to be. Okay. I guess I'll take your word for it. So you want me to take care of him? And to turn back the wheel that is about to crush us? Yes, this is my last hope. Perhaps at least you are a master of your fate? Even Simon cannot boast this title now. Interesting options here. Looks like I can kind of try to flirt. I mean, I kind of want to say I'm only staying here for a day or two anyway. Let's go with that. I'm only staying here for a day or two anyway. I'm not that good at separating the interweaving lines of life, but my intuition is superb. Stay alert, Bachelor. Watch the condemned extend their hands towards you, begging for your help. Will you deny it to them? They are essential for your victory. Everything happens? I don't know what that means, but I definitely don't want to go with this option. Everything happens? That doesn't matter. What was destined to happen will happen. You can be whatever you want to be. But not a coward choosing to hear... No, what is with her face? I just looked up at her face and it looked like she was grimacing or something. Yeah, what is that face right there? It's like she's in pain or something. Anyway. You can be whatever you want to be. But not a coward choosing to hear no evil and run away from reality. I will give you a list of those I know of. These people are bound to you. Oh, is that my list of adherents? Bound? There is a tight spring of power within each of these people. Each of them can break the routine of human existence and become something greater. They are standing on the verge of their humanity, gazing into the realm where they could serve a different, higher purpose, without even knowing it. Moreover, they are bound to make the leap, in one way or another. That's why we call them simply, the Bound. Okay, so super important people that are destined... They're on the verge of their humanity. Destined to become something other than human? Something else? But how is their fate bound to mine? Did you say my victory depended on them? How? I don't know. I'm not a mistress yet. The future is not as clear to me as I would prefer, but I can feel the present. I can already distinguish a dubious guess from the pulse of the precise knowledge, devoid of words and images. These people are bound to you. Your lives are connected. I wouldn't have asked you to take care of them otherwise. It's weird that I can ask her, are you clairvoyant or something, because she already said she was. Yes. You haven't been told, have you? It didn't even cross my mind that someone may be unaware of my abilities. No one here dares doubt them, for they are evident. Yes, the mistress of every ruling house possesses special abilities. I'm learning to see the future and transform the present. Do I want to believe that she actually has these abilities? Sure. Yeah, okay. Let's say I believe her. This fact offers your words a different degree of authenticity. Will you comply with my request? Will you save the lives of the people I named to you? Answer me, before going back to Ava. How do you know that Ava has asked me to come back? I know Ava. She wants to safeguard you from my nocturnal intrigues, doesn't she? She strives to touch the mysteries of our family, to learn the game we're playing. Well, talk to her. Perhaps you two will manage to uncover some bits and pieces of the Kane's dark conspiracy against humanity. But you haven't given me an answer. What will it be? Well, I want to save as many people as possible. So, I don't see any harm in saying yes. Yeah, I will do as you ask, Maria. My honor bids me to. And you'd be better off not giving me cheek. You won't like me- wait, you won't like me when I'm angry, what the hell? Okay. Well, I guess I have to take that bit of dialogue with rest. I don't actually want to say you won't like me when I'm angry. That's weird and creepy. But let's go with that. Whatever happens, these people must live. Their fates are bound to mine. They may well hold the keys to my victory in their hands. Oh my god, this is a long list of people. Okay, so all the Kanes, right? Yep, all the Kanes, also Ava. And a couple people I've never met. Andre Stomatin, Peter Stomatin. Okay, so I guess they're brothers, probably. And Mark Immortal, or Immortel. Look at that smile, that grin. Okay. I will protect them. Oh, look at that, it's a small version of the tree that I saw. There's another version of it. A tree that I saw on one of the other houses. In one of the other houses, rather, and hello, my two friends. Come to say hi. Okay, so I now know what I need to do. I need to find Simon's murderer, and my first step in doing that is to go all the way across town to Isidore Barak's house, because that is the last person, or the last lead, that I have not spoken to. I've got a feeling they're not going to be there. It feels way too easy if I just go there and I'm actually able to speak with them. But we'll see. And I'm sure I'm going to see many strange things along the way, too. Look at all these places I could visit. Yeah, so by the way, every single red house or red building on the map is a place that you can enter. Like a super important place, basically. And I'm not sure about the other places, the ones that are like tan. I went to one tan building, this one here, and it was a shop, so maybe all the tan buildings are shops. Yeah, this game world's pretty big. Alright, well, I think I'll end this episode here. So far, this game is, well, much improved over the original version. It's nice to read the text and read the dialogue and it actually makes sense. I mean, the stuff people are saying is still very mysterious and strange and hard to understand sometimes, but it's so much better with the new translation. It's not even funny. I would love to see some comparisons, like screenshot or video comparisons side by side showing the old translation versus the new, because I bet you it would be super obvious how much better it is. Alright, well, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I'm going to go speak to these two people helping me on my stage play, or whatever they are, my assistants, and I'm going to go visit Isidore.